In June of 2023, I created 30 designs, a design a day with AI, and I shared it on social media. In this video, I'm going to show you all the designs that I made. I'm going to show you where I made them, some of the prompts that I used, what I learned from it, and much more. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to share with you what I learned by doing 30 designs in 30 days in the month of June 2023. So I created AI designs, t-shirt designs, not with words, just the graphics. And I use Leonardo and Midjourney. So I'm going to take you on a journey on what I learned first with Leonardo. I used that first. And then later in the month, I started using Midjourney. So I'm going to show you what I learned there. I'm going to share with you some of the prompts that I used and some of the key words that I think will be very helpful for these prompts on both Leonardo and Midjourney. So let's get into Leonardo first, and I'll show you exactly what I did and how I came up with these designs. So here we are on Leonardo, app.leonardo.ai. You're going to have to sign up for Leonardo with your name and password. I'm already in here. You can see they keep adding more featured models. And I think the latest one is Dream Shaper version 7. They've got this 3D animation style. They also have one in beta I want to show you. If I go to fine tune models, you'll see SDXL.9 stable diffusion. It's currently in beta, so I might want to try that. I haven't tried that one yet. But what I did on here is I'm going to go back to home. So when I first got onto Leonardo, this is what I did. I looked through some of these and looked what could be a t-shirt design like this. I think this one could be a great t-shirt design, right? It has a white background. You could get rid of those things. And so what I would do is I would just copy the prompt, right? So I can copy the prompt or remix this and hit remix, and it will go right into the AI generation tool with that prompt right there. And it's using Leonardo Diffusion. And that typically was the best one, Leonardo Diffusion. I tried all the other ones, and this would be good. So I would just generate, and it wouldn't be exactly like it, but it'd be close. And I could come in here, and if I didn't want the dog and I want a cat, I could change that too. So that's what I did in the beginning. And then I started playing around with different prompts and stuff like that. So let me show you some key takeaways from here. Always scroll down. I think one of the key takeaways is scroll down and look at what's already been done. I would also go not just on trending, but I would go in each one of these. So I would go on this one and then view more and see if there's anything in here, you know, that looks like a t-shirt. And the same thing with the next one. I'll go back to the other user models and pick Leonardo Diffusion and Deliberate and PG. But what I found was Leonardo Diffusion worked best most of the time. Dream Shaper, I used a couple of times, but for most of the things that I use Leonardo Diffusion. And the one thing that I notice about Leonardo is it's great for faces and designing people. So you can see if I go to fine-tune models, like look at these people here, they're amazing, right? And then there's some like 3D cute characters which do really well. So it's not really geared towards t-shirt design. It's more geared towards animation and video games and those kinds of things that look more realistic or kind of animation style. So you're gonna have to figure out the kind of prompts that you'll need to get some good results. And I noticed that I had to try and refine those prompts every time. And it really helped getting some of those remixes. But when I tried my own things, I had to make it more detailed and ask in the prompt, do this and do this and do this. So I'll show you some of those prompts in a minute. I'll go and show you all my prompts, but those are my main takeaways. Leonardo's great. I came up with some great designs, but that's what I would say is go in here, try them out. Mainly look at Dream Shaper, and you can see what they have here. So I'll go more, and some of these could be good t-shirts. Like this one could make a good t-shirt design. That one. Oh, this one definitely, this dog right here, right? And so on. So just go in here, remix, kind of get some ideas of what it can do, what are the limitations, and then try your own stuff. All right, so let's get into Midjourney. I'll show you what I did there and some of the prompts, and then I'm gonna show you all the designs. So here I am on the Discord for Midjourney. You can see I have the main Midjourney here, which I started off with the Midjourney bot, but then I created my own channel here, Detour Shirts, and this is where I just use the same Midjourney prompts and everything. Someone told me about this, the first video that I made with Midjourney, and it's made all the difference. So I don't have to look at anybody else's stuff. This is just all my stuff now, and it works really the same. And one thing I really like about Midjourney is it really understands like art stuff. Like, it's not just made for video game and faces and people. I think it can understand, you know, kawaii art, or you can see right here, painting. Here's a kawaii one. Here's a, it also does 3D. So it really can understand those kinds of things really easily when you put in the right prompts. And I think it's also great to know some of the prompts in here besides just imagine, hit backslash and know some of these things, info, blend, describe, those things really helped. I have some videos that talk about that. But one thing I would recommend is to use slash info and keep track of your hours. When I got on here, I just went crazy and designed this and did variations of this and upscaled this, and I ran out of my time really quickly. So you can always go in here slash info and kind of look at it periodically to make sure that you don't run out of hours, because it's kind of sad if you pay for a month, what you think is a month, and then you run out in half of the month, and then you have to wait for that to refresh. And that's what happened to me. I had to wait about 15 days before I could use it again. So caution on that. But I think Midjourney is really cool. You don't have to do as long of prompts, and I think it still comes out really great. So those are my two big takeaways. I would say make your own channel. There's lots of videos on how to do that. I'm not gonna show you how to do that here. And also keep track of your time and learn some of these. And you can look at all of these right here and learn them. Just hit slash and then it'll pull up this. And then you can see, oh, this is how you do help. This is how you do info. This is how you do all these other things. I think it's really important to learn some of those things that can help you. So let's get into Affinity Designer. I made a presentation on all the designs and all the prompts and go over some of the takeaways and what I think you should use for prompts if you're gonna do AI design. All right, so here in Affinity Designer, this is where I made my mockups that I shared on social media. So you can see all my designs here. Most of these were done in Leonardo. And so you can see right here, these are all done in Leonardo, and I tried different styles. These mockups were made in Placeit, by the way. They don't come like this. So I took the PNG file, put it in Placeit, and made these mockups, which is really cool. So you can see I have vector style. I have more realistic, some more artsy kind of things. I really love this one. This mushroom one came out all right. The koi fish came out cool. Like, a lot of these are really cool, and I just tried to use different topics that I thought were very popular and just put it in there. And then as I go down here, I started using Midjourney. So this is the start of my Midjourney one. You can see kind of more realistic, but it also did some really good cartoon ones. And then I started doing some mashup stuff, right? And had some fun with that. And it understood kawaii art, which is really cool. And then I did this splattered paint, and this one actually is Leonardo. So those are all my 30 designs, which I think came out really nice. I didn't add any text to it. Of course you can. And I think adding text to designs actually help. Those help sell more. I think more designs out there on Amazon and TeePublic and Redbubble actually have a mix of graphics and text with them, but I wanted to do it really fast. So one way to save time was not to put the text in there. So another quick view of all of them again. Let's go to, I saved a file that have all the prompts on them. So let's go here, and you can see some prompts were a lot longer, some prompts were a lot shorter. You can see all of these, and I put in here what model I use. So Leonardo Diffusion, most of the time you'll see Leonardo Diffusion in here. And then some of these are a lot longer. And here's my prompts for the other ones, Leonardo Diffusion again. And yeah, this one was Dream Shaper, the koi fish, but I think Leonardo Diffusion would have been okay. And you can see Leonardo Diffusion. I think only one of them was Dream Shaper. So here I started using my Midjourney prompts. You can see a lot shorter, like I said. Some of them were longer, like this one. I tried a different style that I saw on there, so I had the longer prompts. And these are some Midjourney ones that are not in the 30 days, you see that it says 29 here, but 30 is right here because it was a Leonardo design. So there's all 30. And this one, I really liked. I did that robot from Leonardo on day 30, and I decided to do it in Midjourney using the kind of the same prompts, and it gave me this, which was really cool. I really like how that came out. And for 4th of July, I thought I would do Washington. So you can see this one is George Washington, just like a cool George Washington, which came out really nice. So those are the prompts for that. And these are my favorites right here. So this mushroom, this is what I use for the mushroom. That's number 7. This is one of my favorites from Leonardo Diffusion. You can see pretty short. All I did was, I like doing in the style of, and you can see vector t-shirt, vector art. I like doing that. And the reason I like doing vector is I notice it's a lot easier to scale it if I do a vectorize AI, and it turns it into a vector which is already designed as a vector, so the quality doesn't change as much. So even though this one is a little more detailed, it's still vector, and so when I did the vectorizer AI, it came out okay. So this is the prompts for that one. And I really like how this one turned out too. Another vector one, you can see the flamingos came out really cool. All right, so takeaways. I said some of these, but I didn't say all of these. So Leonardo, I think Leonardo needs a lot more description to get the design right. I noticed I had to type in more and more stuff. I started with some simple prompts and needed to add more to get it right. I use Remix to get some good prompts and learn from that and use some of those. Like I said, Leonardo is more for people and for gaming, so you're going to have to use those better prompts to get some of the other stuff. And you need to use the right model. Like I said, a Leonardo Diffusion or DreamShaper, I think, are the best ones. I liked adding t-shirt design in my prompt. I thought that really helped. And vector art, again, is easier to scale and color, like I said. And I liked putting in white background or black background in the prompt so that I can remove those backgrounds a lot easier, especially when it's a vector and I bring it into something like Affinity Designer. I can remove that background. For Midjourney, kind of the same. I really had fun with the different variations, which is easy to do on Midjourney. You can just hit variation, right? And then it didn't need as much description as Leonardo, I found out, at least for the ones that I did. And then I used /describe to get a good prompt. So if I found something that I liked online, I could drag that in into Midjourney and use /describe, and I would get some really good prompts, kind of learn how Midjourney thinks about the prompts for a specific design. And so I could take some of those keywords, which is really cool. And then again, like I said, be careful of your minutes. I ran out. You can use info to keep track, create your own channel, like I said, and check your settings with settings on what you're designing for. So it's usually set at the highest setting for Midjourney, but if you want to try other settings, you can use /settings. Okay. And this is a basic prompt that I would say works pretty well for most of the time. So I would say do a vector t-shirt design, comma, vector art with black outlines. I like black outlines personally. I think it looks better to outline it. You don't have to do that. And then describe the design. And I like to use in the style of, if you know what kind of style you're doing, kawaii style or you know, splatter paint or whatever it is. You can do a style of an artist as well. So describe the design. Don't put in describe the design. That's just a prompt for you to describe what it is. So if you want to do a unicorn, you know, with flowers, put that in there in the style of kawaii, right? And then I like using the word clip art in there. That kind of helps define it. And then illustration also lets them know that it should be drawn. I like putting 3 colors only to kind of limit the colors. I don't know how well it understands that, because a lot of times I put 3 colors only and it still gives me lots of colors. And then either black background or white background. I typically like black background just because I know I'm going to put it on a black t-shirt. So when the AI does it for a black background, you know it's going to look good on a black t-shirt too, and you can remove that black background. So hopefully that really helps there. All of this, I think, was just a learning thing, and I think you can do it as well. So if you want to try it out, you don't have to try these prompts, but I think doing something for 30 days will really help you learn something about that. So it doesn't have to be AI. It can be drawing for 30 days. It can be uploading for 30 days straight or those kinds of things. So pick something that you really want to learn how to do and do it, in this case AI. And you know, you can start with these, but there's lots of different things that you can do on here. You don't have to do unicorns and flamingos. You could do cats and dogs and whatever you want that's important, that's popular coming up. I would actually do some Halloween stuff if you're doing stuff right now, because that's going to be really popular. So have fun with this. Hopefully this was really helpful, like I said, and you can learn from what I learned and do it on your own. So there you go. That's everything that I learned from doing 30 designs in 30 days with AI in June of 2023. I'm going to continue to do more AI designs, I think, as I learn and see how this works. I'm going to try and do designs and add text with them this time, so I can slow it down so I don't have to rush it. But I think that can really help as well. So think of designs that you would put with text. And I think that can really help if you don't want to just do designs by itself. Because I think typically, like I said, designs with text do a lot better. Not to say that designs by themselves don't sell, because they do. Some of them sell really well. This kawaii is an example. This corgi doesn't have any text in it. But typically, graphics with text do better. So my hope is that you can learn from what I did and do some of your own. If you want to learn more about AI design, I have a whole playlist that I'm putting together. I'll put it right here with Midjourney as well as Leonardo stuff. You can learn all of those in there. I have a bunch of them. You can learn about Remix and how to do different prompts and things like that, how to use Vectorizer AI or other things like that to upscale your stuff. So thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.